Well, come on in, folks. This is 1516 Longworth. This was Mike Pence's freshman office. And a lot of people have had it before me, and I'm honored to be here. It's kind of a small office, but this is home. And sometimes I sleep on the couch. Last night I slept at a hotel north of the Capitol complex here. But I'm here in the morning getting ready. We've got a busy schedule. I want to show you. Where's the schedule? This is it. This is what we're doing today. Every day, the day before, our scheduler gives us a schedule and kind of lets me know throughout the day what we need to be doing. So we're getting ready now. We have a Bible study at 8, then a meeting back here, National Federation of Independent Business, and then we'll go from there. It's a busy day. So welcome to A Day in the Life with a congressman from Missouri, the Show Me State. Today, we're going to show you what being a congressman is all about. Hey, how's it going?
Good morning.
Look at the spread in here. This is Rudy.
Great.
And Randy, and this is his office in Cannon.
Welcome.
Very nice office. Yeah.
Glad to have you here.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Thanks for coming to Bible study this morning.
My pleasure. We're heading back to the office now. We've got a meeting with, National Federation of Independent Businesses. And it's 5 till 9, and we got 5 minutes to get there. How are you?
Good morning.
Mark Alford.
Charlene,
good to see you. Hi.
See you.
Mark Alford.
Jan Hathaway.
Good to see you, Jan.
Nice to see you.
Scott, I like that. Well, good to have you guys here.
Good to be here.
Good to be here.
This is a lot of you guys from NFIB up here.
I'm your state director.
Yeah.
We met.
Yes, I remember that.
And a couple on the campaign trail.
Uh-huh.
So thanks for taking a few minutes.
Yeah.
This is the letter the Small Business Committee and China Select Committee is leading to the Attorney General about China stealing our intellectual property from small businesses. I recommend we get on it.
Okay. It looks good to me.
Great. I'll get on it.
Thanks. The Ag Committee room on the third floor now, just two floors down from our office. I'm Mark Alford.
I'm Caroline. Nice to
meet
you.
Good to see you. Hi, I'm Mark Alford from Missouri. Good to see you.
Yeah, thank you for having this hearing.
Whoa, we're appreciative.
Yeah.
Any bit of knowledge that we can apply to making the decisions. So that's the way I look at it. Dana, how are you?
How are you? Good to
see you. Miss Tanya, how are you doing?
Good.
You're looking nice today.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Thank you for that note.
You're welcome.
Thank you. That meant a lot to me because I've been coming up here for 8 years. My first note.
Really?
Yes.
We need to do that more for each other.
Yes.
Encourage each other.
Yes. You going to the baseball game tonight?
I am. Are you?
No. When I leave this city, I'm going to the country. I'm back in the country.
Well, good seeing you.
Thank you, doctor. All right, I'm going to throw out a jump ball question. That means anyone jump in on this answer, all right? I'm a member of the Congressional FFA Caucus. My dad was an ag teacher. He led FFA, great organization. I'm curious to know how each of your institutions work with youth development programs like 4-H and FFA to recruit the next generation to get this this vibe going in America again, where ag is so important and we need to look to the future. Anybody? Yes, sir, Dr. Engel.
Yes, just very briefly, FFA State Convention on our campus this week. So near and dear to all things we do in our college, and I think that's true at other institutions as well.
How's everybody doing? Good to see you. Good to see you again.
How are you?
Your daughter's here?
She is. She's right there.
Hi, Mark Alford. Good to see you. Yeah, your grandmother texted me, said you guys were coming, so good.
We're the electric cooperatives,
mm-hmm.
and so they have written an essay or done a speech to earn this trip about electric cooperatives, and so they get an all-expense-paid trip by the electric cooperatives to come out here, tour D.C., meet our representatives, and just make some
time. How you doing?
Great.
Welcome.
Chad Mahoney.
Mark Alford. You're the new president?
I am.
Good. Yeah. Good to see you. Yeah. Hi, Mark Alford.
I'm Becky Damian. Nice to meet you.
And where are you from?
St. Louis.
St. Louis. Good to see you. Hey, good to see you again. You all right?
Zimmer, I'm doing great. Good to see you.
Congressman Brian McDonough.
Mark Alford. Good to have you here. And you're with KY3?
I am.
All right.
Tom Brand, National Association of Farm Broadcasters.
Oh, well, good to see you.
Ago here
yes.
Good to see
that's
you.
Right. Well, thank you. Have a seat, guys.
Thank you.
I'll sit right here so I can take notes. Hi, everybody. I'm Mark Alford, your voice and your vote in Washington. Today is Flag Day. We celebrate the Stars and Stripes with the respect that it deserves, hung properly according to the U.S. flag code here, right outside the U.S. House chambers. Thank you to all who have given the ultimate sacrifice. Thank you to our veterans, and thank you for respecting the greatest symbol our nation ever has. Good to have you here. I'm Mark Alford. Is this your first time here?
Huh?
Is this your first time here?
First time. First time in Washington, D.C.
Well, glad to have you. I'm a congressman from Missouri. We're in the middle of the United States, yes.
Alfing is beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. City is beautiful.
Good.
Beautiful.
People are friendly.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Is everyone being nice to you?
Yes.
Chris,
yes.
That is journalistic malpractice. That is activism. That is not journalism. It's one reason I left the business that I held dear for 35 years. It is not the media's job to go on the air and say what is truth and what is a lie. You present what's out there, and you let the viewers, your client, that you have a fiduciary responsibility to determine what's true. It's not your job. And yet, students are taught in school, young journalists are taught in their early jobs, and it continues through the medium and even the higher levels, especially when you get into these places like CNN and MSNBC, that it's your job to afflict the comfortable and comfort the afflicted. That's not the job of the journalist. The job of a journalist is to tell what happened and let the chips fall where they may.
We're now going to a skiff, secret compartmentalized, top secret location to have a classified briefing on TikTok. So this is the third floor down here. And hey, Gus, this is the skiff that we're going into, restricted area, so I got to leave you here, and we'll be back. Okay, just coming out of the skiff, and now we got to go vote. We have 13 votes in this series.
Okay, who's back waiting for house floor?
Hey, how are you?
Good to see you.
Good to see you. You all right?
Are you playing today?
No, I'm watching.
You what?
Good to see you. So I'm about to go to the house floor to vote. We have 13 votes, and we'll see you after that. Hello. How are y'all doing?
All right.
Good. How's it going? Good to see you again. Not too late, are we?
No.
Good. I've got to do a little shave and makeup here real quick. All right, that's good enough.
All right.
Let's go. Hi, everybody. Welcome back. I'm your congressman, your voice and your vote in Washington, Mark Alford, with this week's Capitol Recap. Man, what a day. It's a long day, but we're not done yet. We're back in the office, but we got the congressional baseball game to go after that over at National Parks. I got to change clothes. We'll see you at the game. Go Republicans.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are finishing this beautiful day, the day in the life of Congressman Mark Alford. We're at the big baseball game. We're at the Nationals Baseball Park in Navy Yard. The Republicans are taking on the Democrats. This is our wonderful congressional team here. Say hi, guys. Let's go in.
Holding my lover with the other. A sweet, soft southern thrill. Worked hard all week